everyone. I am here today to do a color and chat. Believe it or not, it's Friday afternoon or evening actually now. And I am done with work. So I thought that I would try to do a small color and chat for you guys. I haven't done one in a while. I've been doing a lot of flip-throughs and stuff. I'm just going to zoom you in a little bit more. So I've been doing a lot of flip-throughs and stuff. And I wanted to try and get a color and chat up for you. So I have a lot of things to chat about today, and I know I'll probably get some questions. So what I'm working in is called Mounts 4, and this is by Olga Goloveshkina. That's what I'm going with. I've worked in this book before, and I'm working on the bunny now. He looks very neon, but he doesn't quite look like that in person, so the camera is distorting it a little bit. But I'll show you some of the other pictures that I've done. I did this one last year. These are all Halloween pictures. I adore this book, and I was hell-bent on getting one done this year. I think this was the very first one that I did. And actually, if you go on Olga's Instagram, you can see a sped up video of me coloring this. She found my video and she liked it and she put it on there. So that was really nice. And she has a Christmas Mounts book, which I also have. And I colored in it last year, and she has a pug in that book. So of course I was getting that. So I think that's all that I've done in this book. So now I am doing at least this one this year for Halloween. So let me move the bunny up. All right, so I'm using for right now my Luminance pencils. So I guess I'll show you those. I do not have the full set of Luminance. I've so far just collected the ones that I wanted, and I have three out that I'm gonna be working with today. But these are all the ones that I have that I wanted, and I have them in this little pink case, which is very nice. And I got a smaller case for these because I am running out of room, so I needed to get a small case. So I'm just going to go in and put the white in the places where I want the highlight, and then I'm planning to do the wings purple. So hopefully we'll get to that, but you know me, I talk a lot, so we'll see. I'm also standing while I'm filming this, so I don't know how far I'm going to get. We'll see how long it takes for the paint to kick in, but so long time no color and chat. And before I get started, I just want to say that for the past week, I have been nonstop watching Simon Pegg Nick Frost videos or movies. I guess I should say not videos, movies. The Cornetto trilogy. So for those of you that watched my live stream, you'll know that my new current obsession is Shaun of the Dead. I've always loved it, but at this time I am currently quite obsessed with it. I actually watched it twice in one day, and I usually put it on while I'm coloring, and I did end up watching World's End yesterday and Hot Fuzz and Shaun of the Dead. So I watched them all yesterday, and I've been doing this all week watching Shaun of the Dead. So the reason I'm telling you this is I've also been watching Sammy from Color and Chat with Sammy. I've been watching her gnome video, and my intention is to follow along with her because I have the Gnomes in the Neighborhood book too. I haven't done anything with it yet, but she has two videos up on it, and I've been watching them. So I've been listening to her and listening to Simon and Nick, and if for some reason during the video I slip into a British accent or start saying some of the verbiage that they use, don't be surprised, because I've been going 24/7 on the Brits. So no complaints from me. Absolutely love them. And I'm obsessed with probably a lot of British people because, you know, my number one dream guy from my soap opera Days of Our Lives, who my son is named after, EJ, he was British too. So there you go. I guess I have a thing for the Brits. So anyway, I will probably slip into some things that they say. So just don't worry about me. So I don't know if I said this when I started, but we're expecting a big nor'easter here on Long Island tomorrow, or at least in the north, the northeast. It's not supposed to be any snow, but it is supposed to be lots of rain and thunder and wind. So, you know, nothing crazy, but we will probably be in the house all day tomorrow. It's supposed to keep up all day and night. So when Frank comes home, he'll go do the food shopping, and I'll stay home with Emilio, unless Emilio wants to go. Because then that's my free time to get some things done around the house. I usually get my laundry started and put laundry away and things like that. It's just a little quiet time. So I will probably do that. He'll pick up some food for us, and then we will have a nice quiet night, all of us together. I don't know if we're going to go out and look at any Halloween lights tonight. It's a possibility, so I'll have to let you know next time I do something and update you. But yeah, that's a possibility, but we are probably going to be in the house most of the day tomorrow. So Sunday we will go out. I have to get my nails done on Sunday. I don't know what else we're going to do, but we will see. And also, as usual, my coloring assistant, he's quiet at the moment. He does understand now when I tell him mommy's going to film, so can you be quiet? So he does understand that concept now. I don't know if that made it worse or what. I'm going to put the overhead light on. Make it a little bit brighter. So I don't know if he understands that or, well, no, I do know he understands that, but I don't know how long it's going to hold out, so we shall see. He's being a good boy and watching his iPad right now. Oh, here he comes. He heard me say his name, so prepare. Also, all of my dogs are walking around right now, so you might hear the clicking of the nails. And that's that. So, like I said, I have a bunch of things to talk about today. This video is probably going to be all over the place, but we'll see. I didn't really make too much of an agenda of anything I wanted to say, but since it's been a minute since I've had a proper color and chat and not a stream, I have things to talk about. So, it's been a fun month of coloring, I must say. I have had so much fun doing Halloween pictures. I started in very early September and I have not stopped. I mean, I've colored a few in between pictures along the way, but for the most part, it's been all Halloween all the time and I have loved it. I'm gonna be sad to see the season go. It's been fun. We've had not such great weather the last few weekends. And we went at the very beginning of the month pumpkin picking, because when if it hits like the end of September, early October, if the weather's nice, I like to go and get it done because I never know how the weather is going to be for the rest of the month. It is still hurricane season here, so I don't want to miss out on the pumpkin picking. So we went, I think we went on October 6th, and we picked out our pumpkins and we had a really good time. And that's really been the big Halloween thing that we did this year. A lot of the other weekends were crummy weather. And then last weekend, last Saturday, I actually had my very first interview for coloring. And this will probably be going up tonight. And the podcast was going to be released tomorrow. So I will be providing a link on my Facebook page for you guys to go and listen to it. And I will probably, after I get the link from Isabelle, I will go ahead and pop it in the description of this video when it's finally live, because it's going to be going live on Saturday. But yeah, I had an hour-long interview with Isabelle for her podcast talking all about coloring, and we had such a good time, and then I actually provided extra content for her Patreons, and we talked a little bit about things there, so that was a lot of fun, and we have other things in the works, so I'm really excited about it, and we had so much fun, and she was so sweet, and yeah, I'm not going to say really anything else about it because I want you to listen to the podcast and see what you think about it, but I was really just so honored to be asked to do something like this. You know, I'm no fantastic colorist. I'm just a beginner, and to be asked to do this, I just was really honored, and I'm so excited for you guys to hear it. So, like I said, I'll pop a link in the description when it's live so that you can go check it out. And then I will also be putting the information on my Instagram and my Facebook group. So, if you want to join the Facebook group, please feel free. The link, well, it's not really a link, it's just directions below. It's really simple. I got a message that somebody had a hard time finding it, but I'm not sure how, because I went and looked to see if I could find it, and it was really easy. You just go to your Facebook, and in the search, you type in Reading with Pugs, all one word, and then space coloring, and it'll bring up my group, and then you just ask to join. So that is how you find us, and if you'd like to join, please come over, because we have a wonderful group of people over there, and it's a lot of fun. And for those of you that know Color and Chat with Sammy, she's actually one of my beautiful moderators. So I'm very blessed to have her in our group, and thankful for everything that all the moderators do for my group. So if you guys are watching, I just want to say a big old thank you so much for all that you do, because I couldn't do it without you guys. So, yeah, so that's an exciting thing that happened, the podcast. And I've had so many books to share with you guys. I guess this is the season where just books are coming out now, and we're buying them. At least I know I am. And I'm pretty sure my people in my group are buying them too. I guess this is the season they're rocking them out, and we're totally suckered into it and just buying up a storm. But if you hear my voice going in different places, it's because I'm moving around. So don't think you're like your ears are going funky or anything. It is me moving around. I have to, because of the way that the camera is positioned and how I color. So yeah. And I'm excited about all the things that we have to color coming out, and all the things that are out. Clara Markova's new book is out, which I'm waiting till it goes on to Amazon to get. Emily Lightholt Olberg has just re-released Sagar Ox Sagner, so you can get that on printworksmarket.com if you missed out on it the first time. And I believe right now, which today is the 26th, October 26th, I believe right now there's a 15% coupon somehow, some way. So maybe you want to look into that. I don't know how long the coupon's going to last or anything like that. I bought Sagar Ox Sagner when it originally came out, so I'm not going to be buying like another copy of it. But I know so many people missed out on it, so that's really exciting. I think really soon Mardell Rubio's new book is coming out, the Zodiac book that was supposed to be out in September. I believe it's coming out November 1st, unless they pushed it back again. I know that his publisher, and I can't think of who it is, but I know his publisher was having issues with the paper, so that was the reason that that one got pushed back. And I could be wrong, but I really think that he's working on another book now, but I'm not sure. Of course, there's always the Coloring Haven, or Coloring Heaven, I think it's Coloring Heaven, magazines that are out that you can buy that usually have like a compilation of coloring book artists. I have been getting mine at Barnes & Noble, but now they don't seem to have them, so I wasn't able to get the Halloween one, and I'm probably not going to be able to get the Christmas one, so I might have to order it from their website, which is, I don't know what it is offhand, but if you just look up Coloring Heaven, you'll be able to find it. But there's always those as an option, and I know that Hannah Lynn is working on a steampunk coloring book, so there's that that's coming out. Oh gosh, there's so much. The World of Flowers by Johanna Basford just came out, and I just finished filming the flip through for that, so that will be up probably tomorrow. And there's so much. There's just so much. What's her name? Maria Troll said a new book is going to be coming out in the spring. Clara Markova is working on a new book. So, folks, in short, save your money, because we're about to do it again and buy all new books. I'm going to have to make some more room in my cabinets, because Mom is running out of space over here. There's actually a young lady at... well, not at my husband's job, but she's a daughter of someone that my husband works with. And she loves to color, and I just found out about this, so I have some things that I'm going to donate to her because she really doesn't have anything, and she's really into arts and stuff like that. So I have some products and coloring books that I'm going to give to her, and I've already given her some stuff, and she was super excited about it, so that makes me happy. So, yeah, so making room for more stuff. And I've had some questions about my Amazon wish list. So I'm just going to address this here. I know not everyone's going to see this, but I'm just going to put it in this video and hopefully people will see it. Yes, I have an Amazon wish list. No, it is not posted and I do not post it. It is just for my eyes and for me to buy from. And I completely appreciate the offers and the messages that I've got from people wanting to purchase for me from there, but that's just not my thing. I'm just not into that kind of thing, and I would so much rather you spend the money on yourself or donate it to like an animal fund, you know, like someplace that has an animal, like a pug rescue or, you know, something like that. Like I said, I am definitely not ungrateful. My apologies, my coloring assistant needed a beverage refresh. So I'm not sure where I was, but I think I was just saying I really, really, really appreciate the offers and the questions about the list, but I just, yeah, it's just not my thing. So I appreciate it, but please spend the money on yourself. And if you want to send me a card or a picture that you colored or something like that, my P.O. box is always listed in the description. I do leave it down there for any cards or if any, sometimes a like an independent artist will contact me and send me stuff. I've received stuff to the box that I've not even known about. That's why there's that disclaimer in there that I don't review everything that I received in the box. So, yeah. So that's why that's there. So if you wanted to send me a card or something like that, I would love it. Or sometimes I do receive like colored pictures and things. So that stuff is always welcome and appreciated. So again, thank you so much to everybody that's asked. It's just, not my bag, baby. So, thank you. So there's that. So, the luminance work really nice on this, I have to say, even though this is create space paper. I don't seem to be having any problem. Of course, you know, it is layers, so there's that. And if you don't want to do layers, create space paper and pencils are just not the only thing that you should use. Definitely use some sort of like marker or water or something like that if you don't want to do layers. Because not everybody does, but I like the challenge of it, to be honest with you. I didn't used to, but now that I've just like slowed up on my coloring and stopped putting so much pressure on myself to get things done, I've just been enjoying the challenge of doing it. So that is actually a good segue into one of the things that I wanted to talk about. I just wanted to talk about a few things that have like come across my email and like things that have happened, because one of the last color and chats that I filmed, I was kind of really down. You guys may remember I had some things going on in my personal life that were really hard that I was going through, and I honestly was just at my lowest point ever that I ever remember being during that time. I was nightly crying myself to sleep over what was going on, and I was so disheartened and like just searching for answers, like, why is this happening to me? And it was just like, you know, that phrase, and the hits keep on coming. That's how it was going at that time. It was just one thing after another, and I was just so down, you know. I was really just going through the motions of every day, but I just didn't want to. Like, it was just one of those times where I didn't want to get out of bed. I just wanted stuff to straighten out, and I didn't know how to straighten it out myself. And I mentioned, like people stabbing you in the back and stuff like that. And I was lost. I was a lost lemon drop, and I didn't know how to get out of it. And, you know, my really good friends, I talk about them a lot, but they're my really good friends, like some of my best friends in my life. Mona, who's become like one of the closest people ever in my life. We talk every day. Sammy, who I talk to pretty much every day. My friend V from Color and Chat. No, Coloring at V's, I think that's the name of her channel. We're very close. We talk all the time. My mods all reached out to me just to say, hey, what's going on? Because obviously I didn't have much content on my channel for a few months there. I really wasn't too active in the group. I mean, I was visiting it, but I was just kind of there, you know? Like, I was just kind of there, like, that, there but not there, you know? And my friends all reached out to me and asked if they could help. And I just, I appreciated it, but I really didn't even know what to tell them to do. Like, what do I tell you to do when I don't even know what to do, you know? So they just constantly would stay in touch and say, I'm here if you need me, which was so appreciated. But again, I didn't even know what to do in that situation. So I couldn't, I barely talked, you know, I just said thank you and whatever. And I think Mona and Sammy both, I think V knew too what was going on for the most part. And then one day, it was a particularly bad day, and I was upstairs working, and I was alone, obviously, because I was working, and I said in my head or out loud, I don't remember, it was one or the other, but I said, God, please help me. I need help. I'm miserable and I don't know where to turn or what to do. I don't know why this is happening to me. And I think I even mentioned to you guys that I had stopped praying because I was so disheartened at what had happened to me, and I couldn't understand why God let this happen to me. And it was just, yeah, it was bad, you know? It was like a bad situation. So I was in such a bad spot, and I hadn't been praying, and I didn't know where I was, and I was lost, and I just said this thing out loud, and I just was like, I just needed something, some help from somewhere, because I didn't know where to turn anymore. And after work that afternoon, I was sitting on the couch, and I don't know what I was doing. Maybe I was just looking at my phone or whatever, but it was right after work was over. And I got a message on Instant Messenger from Dee Dee Willingham, for you, those of you guys that don't know her, but I'm sure everybody knows her. So I got this message, and she was just saying to me, she was checking in on me to see how I was doing. She had watched my video, and she felt bad for what was going on. And she talked to me for a good hour, at least. And I don't even think I ever told her this, but she is the one who broke me out of the misery that I was in. And she, you know, I mean, I'm not gonna talk about what we talked about, but she made sense with me. And I do remember that I did say to her, you are the answer to my prayer. And she was absolutely the answer to the prayer, because she, I'm sorry if you hear that disgusting noise, it's one of my dogs barfing. He's not barfing, he's just like choking or something. It's just a thing pugs do. This is gonna be a fun video. So yeah, she just came to me, and it was like, people had been talking to me, my mother, Frank, family that I knew, you know, that knew about what was going on with me, my friends, they had all tried, but something about what she was saying to me saved me. I know it sounds funny, but Dee Dee saved me. She brought me out of that funk that I was in. she made sense with me. And maybe not at that moment. It wasn't just like, now they're sneezing and snarfing. I'm so sorry, these dogs. I should have left them downstairs until I was done. Okay, anyways, so she made sense with me, and it wasn't like at that moment that it was just an aha, oh my God, it's broken, I'm broken from the spell. No, it wasn't like that. It was just what she said made sense. I thought about it over that night, and the next day I did start to feel better. And then little by little, things just started changing for me. I realized what I had to do in that situation, what I had to do to make it right for me. And she did that. You know, I can't say she didn't. She did that for me. She helped me see things that I couldn't see. And I will never be able to thank her enough for that. Yeah, she changed it all for me. And made me see the light and how I could get out of the darkness. And sometimes you just need that person. And I believe that God sent her to me to do that, because nobody else seemed to be able to get through to me on what was going on and how to see things differently, you know? And she did that. So Dee Dee, if you're watching this, I thank you from the bottom of my heart, because I don't know if, I feel like I would have never gotten out of that without your help. You made sense with me when nobody else could. And I always think back to our conversation. And I mean, not only about that situation, but I changed as a person because of that situation. At first I changed for the worse, and then I changed for the better. So, I'm so much of a happier person now after going through all of this and living it and working my way through it and just finding out things about myself. Things that were making me miserable that I needed to work through and get over, like literally just get over it and find a way to get through all that minutia that was going on in my brain. And be a happy person again, because sometimes I would text Frank and when he was at work, and I would say, I'm just miserable. And he would say, why? And I'm like, I don't know, but I'm just miserable. And it wasn't depression, it was misery, like hopelessness and misery because of what happened to me because of the situation. And I have to say that after all this time, it's been some months since the whole thing happened, but I'll be honest and say that I honestly see now why it happened, and I'm so thankful that God put me on the path that He put me on, because if I had gotten what I had wanted in that situation, I would have been absolutely miserable right now. So I had to go through misery to get to the realization that there's a reason, and I will get through it, and I'll see the reason, and we're there. I see the reason that this happened. So it took some getting to, but I did get there. And I think we always do. I think sometimes we just lose our way. And if we're open enough to get that help from somebody and we're willing to listen, that's when it happens. I think that all those months, I just wasn't willing to listen to what I didn't want to hear. And only when we're open to it and open to letting go of stuff is when things start to change for us. You know, I heard a saying a long time ago that if you have a problem, put it in God's box and let Him deal with it. And it's very hard to do that, because I think as a human population, we worry about stuff and what is the outcome going to be, you know? And we want to try to make it our way on our time and our terms, and it doesn't work that way. At least not for me. You know, people that are not religious are not gonna like be into this or whatever, but I have to talk about me. This is me, this is the person that I am. And this is my faith and what I believe in. So I feel like in any situation in life, even if it doesn't have to do with religion or anything like that, if you're going through something and you can't find your way out of it, it's because you're not letting it go. It's only when you are finally open to letting it go does that situation finally turn around. And I'll give you an example of what I'm talking about. My very first, like, real boyfriend that I really loved, or at least I thought I really loved him back in the day, but he was, like, let's just say my first, like, real serious relationship. And we were on again, off again for 5 years. And we were young. I was, what, 19? And he was 20 or something like that when we first started dating. So we were young and we were stupid. And to be honest, he was a perpetual liar. I don't know if he still is. We do talk, but yeah, I don't know what his, you know, what he does in his life or whatever. But he was a liar, and he was one of those that just kept me hanging on, as they say. So, yeah, he kept me hanging on for 5 years, and I was heartbroken, and I wanted him, and I wanted to marry him, and he was my true love, and that was what I wanted to be, and I couldn't meet anyone else that would change it, because that's what I was looking for. I figured if I met somebody else that was better, it would just change it for me, and I wouldn't feel that way anymore, but that wasn't so. It wasn't until I woke up one day and was like, you know what? I'm done with this. And I don't know what changed it. I honestly don't, because, you know, the day before I was still head over heels in love with him, but he had done me wrong so many times. And I guess I was just open to it. At that point, I woke up that morning and I was done, and I knew it. And I said, that's it, I'm done. And about 3 weeks later, I met Frank. Now, I had dated other people. In fact, I was dating another firefighter when I met Frank. But there was nothing there. You know, there was just that, like, that spark. It just wasn't there. And he was just a really nice guy. We had been friends for years. And we dated, but it wasn't, like, anything serious or anything. He wanted to be serious, but I just didn't feel it. And I met Frank, and it all changed. The very first night I met Frank, I knew I was going to marry him, and he knew it too. It was like this feeling, and that's what I was looking for, and I finally found it. But if I had never been willing to let go of that first one, I don't know that I ever would have met Frank, you know? But something changed, and that's how kind of life goes. All of a sudden, it just changes, and it's only when in your heart of hearts that you just say, I'm done with this. I'm not doing it anymore. I don't want to feel this way anymore. You know, I'm actually done with it. And you mean it. That's when it starts to change. And that's when you can move on. And it's hard, you know, because when you have your heart set on something, you don't want to move on. You want it to just be what you want. But that's not the way it works. You ever hear the, like, a lot of people that have the problem of getting pregnant? Well, you're speaking to one, or listening to one, I should say. Frank and I had tried to get pregnant for a solid year, and it didn't work. And when they told me I had to go for fertility treatments and all that, I was like, no, not doing it. That's just not something that I believe in for myself. I am already on tons of medicines for my illnesses. And I didn't want to mess that up even more. And I was like, no. And Frank and I agreed that this just was not the path we were going to go on. And we both agreed that if it was in God's hands, let him handle it. If we never have kids, well, that's okay. Because we got married to be together. We didn't get married to have kids. So we were perfectly happy. And then one day, 6 years later, I had a line on a pregnancy test, and that was in God's hands. We just let it go. The two of us were just like, that's it. It's not going to happen. So be it. We're together. We're happy. We have a good life. We have our dogs. We were 100% content with each other and our life, and along he came. So it was finally when we settled down to that feeling that, okay, we're happy with what we have. Thank you for this, and we're just going to live our lives, that all of a sudden life changed and along came Emilio. But you know, when you're living that, it is so difficult to just think of things like that. You know, I can stand here and just say this to you. Oh, Frank's home. I'll get back with you. Okay, so sorry. My apologies for that. Frank had just come home from work, so I wanted to talk to him for a little bit. Now, he's gone out food shopping, and I'm here with Emilio. I figured he'd probably want to stay home. It's really chilly out tonight. And like I told you guys, when I go food shopping, I hold everything up, so it's easier if I just don't go. I make up the list, and Frank goes and gets everything, and I stay with Emilio. Plus, Emilio no longer likes to sit in the basket in the cart. He really wants to walk around, and it's hard for one person to just do the food shopping with that, because, you know, you can't take your eye off the kids for a second anymore. So we are here, and I wanted to really stay home and finish this evening. So I have one more video to film after this. So I think when I left off, I was talking about like changing for the better after what I had been through. And I'm just going to be changing my pencils out while we're talking here. I do think that what I went through taught me a lesson and helped me to appreciate what I do have and the friends that I have, and helped me kind of like see things differently. I really have come to the understanding now at this time in my life that, just picking out some colors for the pumpkins, that I have spent a lot of time in my life being sorry for or guilty for things that I do or like to do, worrying about things that I say, worrying about the person that I am, the way that I look, the red skin on my hands, my diseases, and feeling sorry for when, like, I can't get videos up or if I can't see my family because I'm ill. I have spent so much of my life in the 30s just trying to be the version of me that I think that, or at least that I thought that, like, everybody wants to see, that this whole situation that happened to me was a real eye-opener and helped me come to a place in my life that I'm happy with. This is the first time in my life that I can ever remember not being self-conscious, not worrying about my weight, not worrying about what my skin looks like, not worrying about my diseases and how I'm feeling and if I can't go out or I can't do an event or something like that. It has taken me so long to come to this place in life and just be able to stand here and say to you, you know, I'm not affected by people's opinions anymore. You know, the people that matter to me are the people whose opinions I like worry and care about. But people that just try to, who just try to be mean or see you happy and immediately try to put you down for whatever they can come up with, it doesn't matter, you know? And it's taken a long time to get to that point. I used to really worry about, like, what people thought of me when I would make my videos. I would watch pretty much, like, everything that I said and try to monitor the things that I said and really, like, really work hard to not offend anyone. And, you know what? You can't live your life that way. You can't live your life worrying about if you're offending people because you're you. I mean, if you're going around spouting out things that are just inappropriate, well, then that's a different story. And that's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is just being me. You know, there's a thing that happens in this world, in life, on YouTube, where people just don't like you. And that's just the way that it is. And people want to drag you down. And if they see you're happy, immediately they'll go after you for something, you know. And I talked a little bit about this on my stream about my nails. That was my number one complaint that I always got on my channel, was my nails were so ugly, and they hoped I didn't pay for these, and they can't watch my videos because of my nails. And it didn't make me change my nails, but it definitely was something that was, it played into my thoughts. And now I couldn't give a damn what anyone thinks about my nails, because I like my nails. I like them the way they are, and I'm the one that has to see them every day, and it does not matter to me anymore. You know, you could tell me they're the ugliest things on earth, and it doesn't matter to me, because that kind of stuff just doesn't matter. And I think that you have to find that peace in life with yourself before you could be peaceful with other things. And I only found it because I went through this situation. And I really believe it helped me grow as a person. It helped me grow into even more of an adult than I was, helping me stay out of situations that usually I would jump into, or that I would want to voice my opinion about and stuff like that. That was always hard for me to do, like to stay out of stuff. But now it's kind of just like natural to me. It feels like, yeah, well, whatever. I'm just going to stay out of it, and I'm not getting involved. And it feels good. You know, for the first time in my life, I feel good. Like, I really don't care what people say about me. It doesn't matter. If they like me, they like me. If they don't, they don't. And that's the way it goes. That's the way life is. And I'm going to tell you about this funny email that I got recently. I've really thought about this, and like, do I want to bring this up? But I do, because you know what? It played right into my life and what I've come to in life and stuff like that. So I do want to bring it up and talk about it, because it's not just about like YouTube life. It's about real life. And the email that I got was this dissertation from, I don't even remember what her name was, but she was apparently a subscriber. I have no idea. I don't think I ever spoke to her before, but she sent me this big, long email that I will admit I did not read the whole thing. Because I read, I think, like the first paragraph, and she said something to the fact of that she respected me for the most part, but she didn't like the way I had commented to people in the past on my videos. If somebody had left me a sarcastic or rude comment, apparently, according to her, I did not need to respond back that way. But again, I did not read the whole email, so I don't know what the rest of it said. But it was one of those, oh, this isn't out of hate, this is out of love. But then she goes on to say that she only partially respects me. So if you only partially respect me, then it's probably not out of love. It's probably just because you think I should be a certain way that you think I should be. Now, that kind of thinking to me is so nonsensical. Why should anybody be the way that I think they should be? Or why should I be any way that someone thinks I should be? And she was talking about comments, and I'm talking about few and far between here, but she went back and like referenced comments that I had made a year or two ago. I don't know. Very, very weird. And again, the whole point of it was not to be constructive. It was just to make me conform to what she felt I should conform to, and actually what anybody else that commented on the video should also conform to. Whatever way she thought it should be, that's what she was going to let me know. And that's why I didn't bother to read the whole email, because Exactly what I told her in the email was that I don't care what your opinion of me is, because it really doesn't matter. Like, I'm going to respond back to things in my natural way. The way that I feel is the way that I'm going to respond to things, because that's me, that's who I am, that's my natural reaction. And if I have to monitor what I do for my natural reaction, then I'm not being a true me. I'm not being myself. So that's how I've come in life. Like, I've come to this point where I know that this is me, and I'm not going to apologize for being the person that I am, for being the thing, you know, for doing the things that I do, for liking the things that I like, for buying the things that I buy. I mean, this world is so offended by everything. You start to lose yourself in trying to please other people. And that also plays into having your diseases, because when you have chronic pain or you have chronic illnesses, things that will keep you from doing events and stuff like that, I think some part of it is definitely our own, the people that suffer, it's your own perception of what you think people are thinking. And some of it is true to what you're seeing, the response you're getting from people, like, oh, she's sick again, or, oh, he can't go do that, you know, is it really that bad, you know, and things like that. So I think it's one part of this is how I feel I'm being perceived, and one part of I've been perceived like this in the past. So, you know, you kind of label everybody that, well, they must be thinking this about me. And it kind of makes you draw into yourself. It makes you withdraw and not want to go and do things, because you don't want to be judged for being sick. It's not your fault that you're sick, and you don't want to deal with it. So you kind of just go do your own thing. And I think that's one of the reasons that the coloring community is fun and a release for people, because you can come to this place. You don't have to leave your house. You can be as ugly as you want to be, wear your pajamas. Your hair could be crazy. It doesn't matter, but you can still be you. And there are people out there that understand what you're going through and don't judge you harshly for the fact that you're sick. And if there's any message that I can convey to anybody that suffers like I do, it's that don't apologize for being the person that you are, or for being sick, or liking the things that you like, or doing the things that you do, or for your hobbies, or anything like that. This is who you are as a person, and as long as you're not going around committing atrocities or anything like that, you're just being you. That's the best thing that you can do. Because you know something? Life is very short, and we don't even know how short it's going to be for each of us. I mean, gosh, a girl that I know that I met, let's just say on YouTube, I'm not going to say from where or whatever, but a friend that's, I think, younger than me was just diagnosed with breast cancer. And it blows my mind that, you know, in that instant, your whole life changes. And we'll pray for her, and we'll, you know, pull for her, and we want her to get well and all that kind of thing. But, you know, we don't know what the outcome is going to be. That's the truth of any situation. So my point is, life is short, and we're here on this earth for such a short time with the people that we love, with the things that we love to do. We are here, and we're meant to enjoy it and not be worried about what people think. Because, you know, the truth is, if someone's your real friend or someone that really loves you or a family member that loves you or whatever, they're gonna understand what your limitations are, and they're just going to deal with it. They're going to understand, they're going to love you, they're going to support you. And if they don't, then they're not a real friend, then they don't really love you. You know, if a person can't understand a struggle that you go through, whether it's something they've experienced or they're just sympathizing with you, if they can't be that for you, then they're not a true person to you. And I've had to accept that, you know, in life. And it's not always easy. It's not easy to have somebody just walk away from you because you're sick or because you have differences. I got an email from someone, one of our friends in the coloring community recently, saying that she had watched my video where I had talked about my struggles and talked about feeling stabbed in the back and stuff like that. And she said it resonated with her because she had gone through something so similar. And see, now I didn't know this, of course, when I was filming the video. I was just talking about something that I had experienced and what I was going through at the time. But me doing that brought her some comfort because she knew she wasn't alone. There's other people that experience these things, and it somehow helped her. So I think that's why a lot of us make these videos. At least I know that's why I make the videos, so that I can be there to help you guys and get you through if I can, you know, whether it's just to make you laugh with my silly stuff, or if it's to talk about my health issues, or whatever, you know, if I'm just there because you're having insomnia one night and you turn on one of my old videos that you've watched, but it'll bring you some joy just to not be alone and to hear a voice in the background, then that's what I'm there for. And I enjoy doing that. And that's the thing, that, you know, just going back to the friends issue for a second, if someone's not there for you because of whatever limitation you have, then they're not a true friend. And it hurts to accept that sometimes. We don't want to see that about people that we love. We want to believe that they're going to be there for us. We want to believe they're going to accept us for who we are and what we are. And sometimes they just don't. And sometimes people are brought into our lives for a reason, a season, or a lifetime. And you never know what that's going to be. So sometimes you just have to let go. And it's hard. You know, sometimes people will do wrong stuff by you. And you feel angered and upset. But until you let it go, you're never going to be able to move on. So sometimes you can forgive people and you guys find your way back to each other. And sometimes you don't. Sometimes you just have to put up a stand for yourself and just say, you know what, I'm not going to be allowed to be treated like this anymore. I'm done with you and it's over. And it hurts to let go of a friendship. I talked about one of my friendships. She was my lifelong friend forever, since we were, what, like 8 years old or something. She went on vacations with me. We worked together when we got our first real jobs. We went to dancing school together. So sorry. She was there for when my father passed away. I mean, she walked up to the coffin with me and put a flower on it. She was there for everything. And when I met Frank, our lives sort of differed a little bit because she wasn't with anybody. And then we kind of, like, our lives were different. She would want to, like, go out with me and go to bars and stuff. And I was like, I'm married. I'm not looking to go to bars, you know? And when I got pregnant with Emilio, I had texted her and told her, because she was on vacation. And she said, oh my God, I'm so excited. I'll call you when I get home. And that was the last time I ever heard from her. And I can only assume it was just because our lives were just that different, that she just didn't want to be a part of that anymore. I don't know. We didn't have words. Nothing happened. Literally, it was, I'll call you when I get home, and I never heard from her again. And I did reach out to her sister, because her sister and I are friends on Facebook, and I was like, you know, can you give your sister my phone number? And we recently had a reunion for our grammar school, and I was like, please invite her. And she said, okay, I'll give her the message. And I just never heard from her. She didn't show up to the reunion. So yeah, sometimes people just fade away, and sometimes people just don't want to be a part of your life anymore. And sometimes you have to just cut people out. You know, that's just the way it is, unfortunately. You don't want it to be that way, but sometimes that's just what it is. And for everything that you go through in those kinds of situations, I do believe that you grow, you learn something, and you change. But you can't let it change you as a person. And I know from different things that have happened in my past, I started to let it change me as a person and influence the way that I acted and the things that I said and the things that I did. And I thought when it was happening and what I was doing was for the greater good, but in the end, it really wasn't. because I was changing me and becoming unhappy with me because I was trying to be what I thought other people wanted to see. And that's never a good thing. You have to change for you, not for anyone else. Once you start changing for other people, then you're no longer what you want to be. You're just what you think they want to see. And that's not a good look. You know, that's, for the best way to put it, that's not a good look. You want to look like you. You know, you don't want to look like what you think someone else wants you to look like. Sorry, my dogs are barking in the background there. So that's just a little bit about what's happened to me over the last few months or so. I've just changed and come to a place where I'm just really happy with life and the things that I'm doing and how I feel about things. My health is still, you know, pretty much where it was. I'll say, like, you know, the doctor changed my medicine a few months ago, and I'm feeling better. Like, I'm functioning better. This medicine is definitely working for me, so I'm happy about that. And it's encouraging because actually with the medicine that he gave me, I was able to cut down on my medicine. So that's awesome. That makes me happy. There's still good days and bad days for sure. As with anything in life, there's good days and bad days. The only thing that ever really concerns me, you know, as something that I would consider like a real concern, is my pain in my hands and my feet has definitely increased. And there are days when it's hard for me to walk, and it's just because of the extreme pain in my feet. And my concern over it is, you know, as I get older, I mean, I'm only 39 now, but as I get older, how is this going to affect me? You know, my hands are worse. I know that I definitely have lost more strength in my hands because I literally just drop pretty much everything that I touch. I'm pretty good with the pencils. Every once in a while, my nerves and my back will jerk and my hands will go like that. So, like, you'll see sometimes I'll have, like, marks. Like, here's one that I tried to erase on the page. It just happens. Like, I'm not going to freak out about it. It is what it is, right? But I do worry about what the future is going to hold for me. That does bother me. But there's not a whole heck of a lot I can do about it. So I don't spend my time sitting around worrying about it like I used to, because I know that sitting around worrying about it isn't going to change it. So it's not. So why am I wasting precious time, like, sitting around worrying about it? I don't let it take time away from my family or anything. It might be sometimes, like, when I wake up in the morning, like, a fleeting thought, like, oh, crap, I feel like hell. And what happens if it gets worse than this? But, you know, I get up, I get moving, I take my medicine, and I push myself to get through the day. And some days, actually, I'm not going to say some days, most days, I'm able to get through. I've even stopped taking naps. So, I mean, I take the occasional nap. Not going to say I never do. On weekends, I definitely take naps. But during the work week, I don't take naps anymore. And that's a huge accomplishment for me. There may be times where I might need it, and I'll do it if I need it. But for the most part, I don't need it. I'm good. I carry on. I do what I got to do. And, yeah, it's not bad. I'm getting by. I'm getting through. And I'm not just coasting through like I was before. I'm making it. And it's also due to my attitude. I feel different. I feel, like, happier. And more at peace, I guess, is the best way to put it. I feel more at peace. And with that, I just think that I have more of a drive to move every day. You know, I have a little guy. He needs me. he's just a kid and he needs mom and he likes to play with me and I do what I can do to play with him. You know, I make an effort to make sure that I'm there, I'm present, you know. I might not be able to do everything with him that Frank can do with him. You know, I can't sit on the floor and play cars and stuff, but I'll sit with him on the couch and play some toys, like some games and stuff like that. I will watch movies with him. We make cookies together. We do little paintings, like I'll buy little crafts for him to paint in the store, and we work on those together. And I'm doing what I can do, and then whatever I can't do, Frank just picks up the slack on, and we work as a team that way. But I feel good about it. I feel like I'm spending time with my son. I'm not sleeping all the time. I'm doing what I can do with him, and I feel good about it. So things are much better for me. I've had to work to get them there, but they are, you know, they're better, and I'm happy about it. And I just want to give that message to you for anybody that may have gone through the same thing, is going through the same thing, has heartache going on. You can make it through. Sometimes you just need to work on yourself and how you're really feeling and evaluate it and just say, like, why am I feeling this way? What am I doing? Why am I making this worse? What's happening? You know, and I really needed to take months to do that. You guys know I took an extended break from YouTube because I had to do it. It just, there was no choice. I had to do it in order to be me again. And I'm so happy that I'm me again. You see, I'm back and posting and I'm just happy. And for all the people that reached out to me, I mean, I've gotten emails over the months of people just saying they understand, it resonates with them, and I just want you guys to know that I'm doing good. I'm better, and I'm happy, and, you know, big shout out to my friends that have been there, have reached out to me. Thank you to Dee Dee, and you guys helped me, you know, everybody that reached out helped me. And you guys that have stuck around, you help me too. You're here for me. You're fun to hang out with, and we hang out on the Facebook group, and we talk, and it's a good time, and it gets your mind off of your troubles for a little while. It's like Cheers, right? It's like the bar. Everybody knows your name at the Reading with Pugs coloring Facebook group, but it's true. It's like, you know, you walk in, and Ippy's there, and she's hanging out and making jokes and laughing, and, you know, the whole crew is there hanging out, and it's a good time, and it takes your mind off stuff, and I've definitely used the group in that way, and I know other people have too. So sometimes you just have to do what works for you, and you can get yourself through it. It's not always easy. It wasn't easy for me. I went through a lot of heartache and a lot of tears on my pillow, but you know what? I made it. I'm here. I'm better off for it. And I guess that's just the message that I wanted to send to you guys, that I'm better off for what I went through and have learned a lot about myself, and I'm just happy. So don't let anybody tell you what you should be or what they think you should be. You just be you and be the best you can be and be happy with you. I think that's the main thing. Be happy with you. You might have diseases or chronic pain or whatever, but you know what? You're still an awesome person and you still have wonderful things to share with people, whether you think that or not. So don't let anyone take that away from you or try to take away your happiness just for the simple reason that that's what they feel like doing at that moment, because that's crap, and I'm not letting people do that to me anymore. No one's gonna make me feel guilty for things that I like or things that I want to do or for being sick. I've let that go on way too long, and I've lost so much time worrying about other people's perceptions and that kind of thing, and I'm not gonna do it anymore. And I hope that my message here today will help you feel the same way, that you just aren't going to lose any more time worrying about things that you can't fix. I saw this like meme the other day that said 99% of the things that we worry about never happen. And that's so true. I mean, if you think about all the things that you've worried about in the last month, how many of them have actually happened? And did the worrying solve it in any way? Probably not. So that is going to bring me to the end of today's Color and Chat. It was a long one, but I wanted to catch up with you guys. I hope that my chat helped in some way. I hope you enjoyed looking at my cute little bunny here. He's very neon in the camera, but he's not really in life. So look out on Instagram and the Facebook page. I'll be posting my finish of this when I get done with him. And I have a coloring book haul for you that's coming up shortly. And, you know, who knows what else? I'm sure Sammy and I will be doing another cozy coloring night coming up soon, maybe another Christmas one. That would be fun. And we have the holidays to look forward to. There's lots of good stuff. So I want to thank you for spending this time with me today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video.